Greetings, everyone, and welcome to this fun, exciting playthrough of Total War Thrones of Britannia. Yes, if you guys like Vikings, Anglo-Saxons, Alfred the Great, and all that cool stuff, you guys are gonna love this. We'll be telling the story of the Mercian King Ceolwulf and his quest to make Mercia great again. Yes, Ceolwulf, you can do it, my son. Now, if you're an Alfred of Wessex fan, you should definitely go check out my story-based series on Crusader Kings 3, titled Alfred of Wessex. You guys will love it. So, let's have a laugh and enjoy this excellent game together. And yes, you do need to like and comment, or Ceolwulf will visit you while you sleep and carve the Mercian flag into your desk. Greetings, my noble friend, and welcome to England. The year is 878 AD, and as you can see, England is in a bit of problems. Very, very split up at the moment. Down south, we have the powerful West Siacs. Yes, the mighty Wessex, led by Alfred the Great. No matter what you say, we love Alfred, so there we go. But we will destroy you, sir. Alfred is with his noble friends as well. He has some Welsh people at the bottom, and he also has South Siacs. He also has Kent as well. Kent are also allied with him. Over to the east, we have the powerful East Angle Vikings, Guthrud. Very powerful, very strong. We also have a bunch of Vikings which have claimed land once held by the mighty Mercians. We will be getting our land back. Further up north, we have the mighty Vikings of Northumbria here. These guys are very, very powerful, very strong. We may struggle a little bit with them. We have a small Anglo-Saxon kingdom clinging on to life over here, which we plan to help. Further up north, we have the North Laid up here, which is another Anglo-Saxon settlement. We will be helping you guys as well, my friend. If we can, please try and hold on. And we also have some Welsh people and Scottish up there. We also have the Welsh down here. Now, the Welsh hate us. They absolutely hate us, probably because we built a huge dike splitting up their land from our land. We probably are going to have quite a lot of trouble with the Welsh, but we will try and get over there and destroy them as quickly as possible, of course. And then we have the Irish and some other people over there, which we don't really care about. So let us have a look around. Yes, this is our beautiful land. This is the land of the Mercians, of course. Here is our king, Ceolwulf, the mighty. He's not actually mighty, to be fair. People kind of consider him as a bit of a coward, but we will show them. We will show them. Offers Dick. That is probably spelled wrong. That should probably be Offers Dyke. However, whatever, we're moving on. Now, we have a couple of settlements. We have Chester over here. We also have Amsworth over here. Now, this is our capital, and this is where we need to defend, of course. We also have a few other places. Now, these really are Anglo-Saxon names, so I'm not even going to try and butcher them. We also have Uis over here. Yes, this is a lovely little place, and we do plan to try and help this place as much as we can. However, that is bordering the Welsh, and as you know, we're kind of sandwiched in a little bit here, so this is going to be extremely difficult. Of course it is. Let's have a little look at our family tree. Yes, so our father here died. He's left us and our dear brother Snellhelm. So Snellhelm here, he's a wonderful man. He's a wonderful man. He's a skilled protector, so he has been victorious in siege situations on more than one occasion. He is very powerful. Personality, he's a friendly guy. He's an old hand, so he does know how to speak to the men. He is a land lover. Well, yes, we're not going to be sending you out to sea, my friend, don't worry. He's assertive. He will let you know exactly what he wants, and that is it. He's very confident. He's also illustrious as well. So many achievements. This guy is a very powerful man. Absolutely wonderful. You do need a wife, sir. Don't you worry. We will find you one, but not right now because they're expensive. So we have Ceolwulf, our mighty king. Yes, his wife. We're just going to call you Rith, my dear. So Rith here, she's very demanding. Yeah, well, nothing new there then. No, pack that in, Ceolwulf. Pack that in right now, sir. So he's an infamous attacker. This guy is confident and will go straight in for it. Absolutely wonderful. We plan to do that, sir. Of course we do. He's a born commander, skillful, brave. He's handsome. Of course he's handsome. He is the most handsome man you've ever seen in your life. And he's adverse to risk. So he knows what risks are. And he's not just going to go gallivanting in there like some crazy lunatic. So he has two children. He has a lovely lady. He has a lovely daughter called Leofleid. We're just going to call you Fleard, my dear. And then he's got Wilfrith here. Now, Wilfrith is only 10. We're hoping he can grow to be a nice, strong man because he will be taking over once we die. So that's if we die. We may just live forever, ladies and gentlemen. Who knows? So, governors, who do we have as governors? Well, we have Godwin, the mighty Godwin. Now, he's not very liked because he's a bit harsh, so that is a bit of a problem, and he tends to cause quite a few problems. However, he's good at farming and is also quite technical, so he gets industry and things like that are excellent. So, well done. We will keep our eye on you, though, sir. Do not be causing problems. We also have Ethelred here. Ethelred's a very pleasant guy. He is a just man, he's a miner as well, and he's a technical guy, so lots of good things there. We expect good things from you, my friend. We've got Osbald here. Of course, Osbald, very good guy. He's a forward thinker, so he's good for sieges. He's also very good at managing land, so this is absolutely wonderful. He's also got quite a few other good traits there, so absolutely wonderful, my friend. And Harold, we have the mighty old Harold. You have got some grey hairs in your majestic beard, sir, but we love you still. So he's trustworthy, of course he is, and he's prolific and lots of other glorious things. He really is a mighty man, wonderful. So he is our Justiciar at the moment, which means that he basically helps out with the running of justice and things like that. Ethelred here is, of course, our Chamberlain, so he helps with the managing of the realm and things like that, which is absolutely excellent. And our dear brother is our King Captain, so he is the man who commands the armies and things. Of course, we will be commanding armies as well. Of course we will. We've got no statesmen and the family members, as you already know. Absolutely wonderful. Let's have a little look at what we have. So we have Godwin here. He is the governor of Offa's Dyke. Now, we're just going to call it Dyke and not Dick because that sounds very suspicious. We have Ethelred here. Now, Ethelred, we know he's good at mining. So, I'll tell you what we'll do. Let's go through these very quickly. So, here we go. This is Huys. Now, we know Huys is a mining town. It's got some mining villages, so we expect somebody good at mining. Well, that's excellent, because Ethelred here is excellent at mining. It seems you're in the perfect place, my friend. Absolutely wonderful. So, over here, who do we have? Who do we have in South Mercia? Well, we have Osbald. Osbald is an absolutely excellent defender and is good with farms. So that's excellent. Do we have farms? Well, we don't yet because the dirty, smelly Vikings captured them. But we will defeat you, sir. Don't you worry. Don't you worry at all. So that's absolutely wonderful. I think you're probably in the right place there, my friend, I would have thought. However, commerce. We don't have any commerce in this place. So we go to our main capital here. We have farms and things like that. Merchant, absolutely wonderful. So commerce again. Yes, we've got commerce. You seem to be in the right place, Harold. Very good, sir. Now here, over here, we have Godwin. Now, Godwin is harsh, so our public order is quite low because obviously, yeah, so there we go. Stop being so harsh, my friend, Godwin. So Godwin is good at farming and he's also industrial. So if you guys remember, we had this guy, our good friend Osbald. He was good at commerce and our good friend here, no, not you, my dear friend, you're the king. No, this guy here was good with industry. Now, this has got industry and commerce. I think what we need to do is swap these guys around. I probably think we are going to do that, actually. Yes, let's swap those guys around. So you get the old boot, my friend. We are sorry. You will have a position soon, don't you worry, sir. Absolutely wonderful. And then we will set you, Godwin, over here. Absolutely wonderful. So that all seems pretty pleasant. However, this is quite a problem because these guys really are not happy now because Godwin is he's too harsh. Stop being so harsh on everybody, Godwin. God. So over here, all seems to be doing very, very well. So that is very pleasant. We do need to get rid of the mint because this will cause some negative effects. Obviously, our good friend Oswald here will just get richer and richer and he will become a pest. So we'll leave that there for now, but we will be getting rid of that shortly, of course. So what is our plan? Well, our plan is to defeat this little pest over here. This is just a rebel army which will be defeated. And then we're going to push over here and get our land back. Now, the reason why we're going over here is because there's some farms over here and we want this area. Now, I know you guys maybe be thinking, well, go for this guy. Go for this guy instead. Yes, the only problem with this guy here is he is currently allied with nobody. No, he is. He's allied. He's got a defensive pact with these two guys here, look. So if we start a war with him, we're going to end up with these guys. He has no allies. He has nothing. You have nothing and you're practically clinging on to life, sir. So we will help you along the way there. So that is absolutely wonderful. First things we're going to do, of course, is we are going to set our tax level to absolute max. So this is going to be absolutely excellent because everybody's going to, well, you best pay up, sir. So what we've got here is if we have a look at our objectives, if we eliminate these rebels, which we were looking at a second ago, then this will increase our public order, which of course is wonderful. That's what we want. If our public order is increased, then these places here, that will be fine. This will be fine. And these guys really are probably going to kick off and cause some problems. So we do have to keep our eye on that, especially Godwin, because we don't trust you, sir. No, 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 no. So first things first, let's go over and beat this guy. Of course, yes. Who are you, sir? You are Berthun. Okay, Berthun. Prepare to meet our blade, sir. Wonderful. So here we are. Here are our noble men of Mercia. Yes, of course. Look at these guys. You, sir, you need to calm down. You're getting very excited. So absolutely wonderful. This is our mighty king's bodyguards. Yes. So the enemy is over here. So what we're going to do is we're going to set our king over here. Yes, wonderful. And we're going to set our bowman. Absolutely wonderful. And we're going to... apologies, this should have been done. I know what you guys are thinking. You guys are thinking this is not very professional. No, it's not. Apologies, you didn't see anything. You saw nothing, guys. Wonderful. Okay, so now we've all sorted, what we're going to do excuse me you heard nothing, guys. So what we're going to do is we're going to march our guys over here. Wonderful. We're going to march our guys over here. We're going to march these guys here. These guys here, and we're going to get our bowmen out of sight because they'll just get absolutely mullered by their bowmen straight away. So what we're going to do is we're going to cheese this. Now, I know you guys are thinking, cheese it? How are you going to cheese it? Well, quite simple. We're going to send our king here in front of their bowmen, and we're going to get him to shield wall up. They're going to use all their ammunition on our king, and our king, I know you guys are thinking, oh no, not the king, the king could die. No, not in shield wall. The king is very, very powerful in shield wall. Of course he is. So once that's done, they're out of arrows. That's no problem for us then, and then we can march in and absolutely destroy them. Yes. Now I know you guys are probably thinking, Ceolwulf, that is so cheesy. Yes it is. It's very cheesy, but we won't be doing it all the time. We're just going to be doing it on this one battle here because we need to absolutely destroy them and not lose all our men, of course. So here we go. Look how majestic. You are so majestic, men. Absolutely. Not you guys. You guys literally have just got cardboard shields there. You guys definitely do not want to be going in front of the arrows. No, no, no. So absolutely wonderful. Hopefully, fingers crossed, we don't get charged by their cavalry. I do believe our bowmen should be reasonably safe there. And our cavalry are going to go marching through the forest as well. Let us set you guys up. And we also want our infantry over there. So the reason why we're going to send our spearmen here, the guys with the cardboard shields, is because we want these guys to help our cavalry here destroy their cavalry. That is the plan. Now, just our swordmen here, we've got some Siax warriors and our king. They should be enough to hold their main battle. They've only got... I don't think they're going to pressure... I don't think Berthun here is going... He will. He'll end up pushing in and destroying us. But no, I don't think he will. So they've only got some axemen and some spearmen. So these two infantry here should be able to deal with that, while our cavalry, and don't forget our bowmen, will be causing problems as well. So here we go. Prepare for the cheese, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, prepare for the cheese. We love the cheese. So the bows are coming in now. Here we go. Be careful, men. Shield wall. You can see the king. Shield wall, men. Yes, shield wall. Get them all told. Oh, that. As you can see, that is a mighty, mighty flurry of arrows there. Yes, shield wall, men. Here we go. As you can see, no arrows can penetrate the shield wall. Absolutely not, sir. Excellent. So what we're going to do is we're just going to cheese this and let them guys run themselves out of ammo. And we're going to run. You guys need to be a little bit quicker, please. Yes, a lot quicker. So we're going to set you guys there. Wonderful. And we're going to get our cavalry over here. Excellent. And we're going to get our bowmen as well. We're going to group them into group one. Excellent. So what we're going to do is we're just going to get these guys in the forest as well, so they're nice and hidden. That's right, we're very sneaky. We are very sneaky. And as you can see, our king has not lost a single man because his shield wall is too majestic. Bows simply just bounce off. That is how it is. Now, this is slightly worrying that they are actually moving now, so hopefully, fingers crossed, that they just stop. And his cavalry have moved. That is not good. Oh, no. No, don't charge us. Wait until you've run out of ammunition, please, sir. Okay, he seems to have stopped there. Cavalry are moving again. We're not 100% sure why you guys are moving. So he's reacting to our bowmen moving. Okay, no problem, sir. No problem at all. You can do whatever you wish at this moment in time. No, his king has moved forward. Come on, use all your arrows, guys. Use them all. Absolutely wonderful. We've still not lost a man. I know you guys are thinking this is so cheesy. It is. It is the maximum cheese. In fact, I might even put a slice of cheese in the video just in the top corner there, just to prove how cheesy this really is. But still, if it wins, it wins, guys. That's the thing, isn't it? Yeah. So there we go. Wonderful. And they are out of arrows. Absolutely wonderful. Absolutely wonderful. Okay, so we can start to move our men up here. Now, what we want to be doing is we want to be trying to move there. And we want to be moving our king up here. We don't want to be too far apart because we don't want our king to get mobbed. However, we want our... Because as soon as we charge over here, they're going to send their guys to come. And yeah, so you will see how this plays out, guys. You will see. So, we're going to send you guys over. And we're going to send our cavalry. And we're going to get our bowman in the forest there. Absolutely wonderful. He is moving. Okay. So, this is actually great. If we can try and see. Look, he's moving his things there. Look, his axeman. So, what we need to do is try and get... Yes, you go back, sir. You go back. You're not welcome here. Try and move our bowman a bit further up. That is the wrong thing, Ceolwulf. So here we go. Now what we need to do is we need to try and move. He's charging with his cavalry. Oh, yes. Excellent. Charge, men. Charge. Excellent. Right, we need to push as fast as we can now. This is going to be very, very close. Oh, no, he's running. He's charging us. No, run. Get our bowman out of there, sir. Do not be getting into melee combat with you. Oh no, he's caught our bowman. Oh no. Right, excellent. Okay, so hopefully, fingers crossed, we can get our king in position just in the nick of time. Oh no, he's going to flank us from the back. Luckily enough, them guys are pretty garbage. So absolutely excellent. We have managed to chase his... Yes, his cavalry are gone. Absolutely excellent. Right, we need to chase his archers down as soon as possible. Quickly, cavalrymen, go, go, go. Let's see. Make sure you get all his horsemen, men. Do not let any escape. Absolutely wonderful. Absolutely wonderful. Here we go. We're going to try and get our bowmen at the back here so they can start getting some arrows in the rear. And we need to get over there as quick as possible. And as soon as you guys are in position, we will blow our horn. That sounds very, very wrong. Right, charge, men. All glory to the Mercians. Yes, absolutely wonderful. You, sir, get firing some arrows into the back of his army there. He's got his... This is his king, look. Let's have a look at how the war is going. Hopefully, fingers crossed. Yes, we managed to defeat you, sir. Right, what we need to do is we need to try and get our cavalry round the back here as quickly as possible. Go, go, go. Don't let anybody escape, men. Do not let anybody escape. We want complete and utter annihilation here. Yes, of course we do. Here's our cavalry coming in. We're going to do a massive cavalry charge into the back here. And you, sir, you need to stop firing your arrows. Excellent. Absolutely excellent. There we go. This should be an outstanding victory, of course. There we go. His general is getting ready to rout here. It is just an absolute mosh pit of death. Absolutely wonderful. Yes, huzzah, men. Cheers all around. An absolute stunning victory. Yes, don't let them escape. Do not let them escape. There can be no survivors apart from that one man. We will let that one man live. Everybody else has to die. It is the rules, I'm afraid. Cavalry, get charging, please, sir. Wonderful. Absolutely wonderful. So, there we go. First battle is an absolutely outstanding victory. Our king lost a few men, but he didn't die. So, there you go. That is what you get for trying to run away, sir. Thou shalt not run from the mighty Mercians. Yes, kill this man. Kill him. Right, wonderful. So, everybody died except... Where are you, sir? Except this one man here. This one man... With his little dagger, he is the only survivor. Excellent. You go and tell everybody not to mess with the Mercians, please. Absolutely wonderful. Superb. Well, there we go. Stunning victory. All is glorious. Yes, decisive. No doubt that we are victorious, of course. Three men remained. Oh, my goodness. How did three... Okay, well, okay. But we let some of you survive. Wonderful. Death to you, my friend. Now, do we ransom them off? Yes, we're going to ransom them off. Normally, we wouldn't, but because they are Anglo-Saxon rebels, we will be generous. Of course, we will. Absolutely wonderful. We've got a new mission. The lands to the north, while not the richest, are of great strategy. Yes, of course, we definitely need to be getting them conquered. However, they do belong to, yes, they do belong to these guys. And these guys are very, very strong and powerful. So we're not 100% sure we want to be doing that just yet. So no, no, no. Wonderful. Okay, so we have unlocked a skill. Ceolwulf, you are so majestic, sir. What are we going to do? Well, we are going to go for a bard. So everyone stops to hear his humble tune. And yes, absolutely wonderful. This means we will get more men. So men will be coming over and they'll hear the music. And yes, there we go. That sounds wonderful. So first things we're going to do is, if we have a little look here, now we get discount on swords and axes. That is absolutely excellent. And our dear brother here, he gets a discount on spearmen. So what we're going to do is we're going to get our axes from here. Wonderful. And there we go. Now, what this has done is this has allowed us to unlock some technology. Yes. Oh, it's all been planned out, guys. It's all been planned out. This is not a coincidence. So, absolutely wonderful. Melee specialists. Any simpleton can wield a sword or an axe. But you need to be extremely awesome to be joining our little armies. Yes, wonderful. So, we're going to wait for our troops here to replenish, and then we're going to head over and we're going to try and help our brother here. So that is absolutely majestic and absolutely wonderful. What we're going to do is we are going to set off some building as well. What we want to be doing is we want the woodcutter, because that will, if we have a little look, this will mean that our construction cost is less. So that is excellent. So, and I believe we can. Excellent. There we go. See, so when we go to build things, they're going to cost less. Excellent. Absolutely excellent, sir. So what we need from you, my dear friend, is if you could get just some more. Now, can we afford this? We should be okay. Okay, excellent. And we will just get another bowman. Wonderful. Okay. What we're going to do is we are just going to go straight in and get this guy straight away. No messing around. Hang on. Let's upgrade, because if we have a look here, we have got a forge. We've got Tamsworth Forge here, so this is absolutely excellent. So this means our captain here, our dear brother Snellhelm, he now has basic armor, which is excellent. So we're going to go straight over here. Yes, declare war. Yes, declare war, sir. Send over the Cassius Belli. You are in trouble, my friend. So fingers crossed we can actually beat this guy, because we should be able to beat him. Now, I know you guys are probably thinking, are you going to cheese this again? Well, yes, of course we are, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to try and cheese it the best we can, because cheese wins battles, and that's what it's all about. Of course, it's not about entertaining you guys, it's about winning the battles, of course. Ceolwulf. Right, okay, so it's raining. That's a shame. Let's see if we can't wait for... Yes, excellent. Dry. Nice. So, absolutely wonderful. What we're going to do is we're going to cheese ourselves over to this hill over here. And we're going to march over here. So, we have got the high point, of course. We've got the high ground here. That's exactly what we want. Now, we believe that those guys are over here somewhere, because that's normally... Yes, that should be where they are. So, we're going to set our guys up here. Once we're here, we're going to obviously send our king out. Well, he's not our king. He's not the king. He's the general. He is Snellhelm. We're going to send Snellhelm over here, and we're going to let him soak up their ammunition. And then, of course, they're probably going to charge us, and we're just going to go in and mob them. That is the plan, of course. That's the plan. That's always the plan. I promise you guys, if you guys are sat thinking, oh, are you just going to cheese it all the time? No, no, I promise. I promise, once we get some real good guys. In fact, this is the last cheese. Yeah, I promise, this is the last cheese that we use. And then it will be full tactics, proper tactics. No cheesing, I pinky swear it. Come on, guys, you can do it. Just everybody, get yourself over here as fast as possible, please. Certainly is a beautiful place, look. Look at that, beautiful. There's a little small hamlet over there as well. And a little small hamlet here as well. What a beautiful little place. Soon to be full of dead people. Yes. Wonderful. Right, here we go. We are here. So, what do we want? Well, we want our bowmen hidden away. Yes, because we're sneaky. And we want our dear friend over here. And we want our... Yeah, there we go. You, my friend, are probably not going to be able to help all that much. Wonderful. Absolutely wonderful. There they are. Look, here they are. Get your shield up quickly, sir. Now, are we just... Yes, we are just out of range there. Absolutely excellent. So... They're just out of range for us as well. So we'll just wait to soak up some cheese. I'm sorry, guys. It won't take long, okay? It won't take long. Forgive me. Forgive me for the cheese. Yes, guys. You use all your ammunition, men. Now, these are the big axes. These could be a slight problem. We definitely need to keep our eye on them. they could cause problems. What I think we might do is when the time comes, we may just set our bowmen to get those guys straight away because they don't have shields. So we'll be able to just pound some arrows into them, which is the plan. Yes, excellent plan, Snellhelm. Well done, sir. Well done. So they're about to use all their ammo. Right, stop. Don't pause it, though. So let's get our infantry up there straight away. Where's our bowmen? Absolutely wonderful. We want our bowmen to be targeting these guys straight away. Get on there. Get them done, men. Absolutely wonderful. We're going to try and get our... Now, we don't really want to be pushing these guys too far because they will probably die pretty quick because there's not that many men left. However, if we can try and flank a little bit, that would be very pleasant. So, absolutely wonderful. It does seem like these guys are trying to push forward a little bit here. We really could do with setting our king over here to help with their main guy over there, of course. Oh no, our bowmen, no. Right, wonderful, pushing on there, men. Absolutely push. Wonderful, and then if we can try and just get round the back here, and then we can get some arrows pounded in. Absolutely wonderful. So, my dear friend, if you guys can go there, you guys need to be about here, but don't go running off into those. Of course not. Wonderful. Here we go. And the bowmen are chasing us still. You guys are such little tinkers. We will destroy you, sir. Okay, excellent. We have managed to win that. Absolutely wonderful. Push in, men. Push in. Don't let them escape. Nobody can survive. That is the rule. There can be no survivors, sir. Quickly get them. Wonderful. Absolutely wonderful. We have absolutely... Okay. Our knight here. Our captain. He's struggling a little bit. Don't let them get away, men. Chase after them quick. And you, sir, you get after those guys. Absolutely wonderful. Here we go. Can we find their commander? I believe it's this old chap here, perhaps. I do believe that is Snellhelm. Snellhelm, be careful, my friend. Be careful, Snellhelm. You are getting very, very into this. Absolutely wonderful, my friend. All hail you. Wonderful. Don't let them escape. There can be no survivors, men. Chase after them. Snellhelm, be careful. Be careful, my friend. Be careful. Have we got rid of all... Yes. Chase them down like dogs. Wonderful. And you, chase them down. Wonderful. There can be no survivors. Wonderful. Everybody now, just get in on the action. Pretty sure this is their captain there. Oh no, he's killing people. Somebody stop that man quick. Man, he does not give up. You will fight to the very end, sir, won't you? Yes. Somebody kill him quick. He's getting too into this. Oh, what we could do with... is we could do with you coming over here for the flank, push into the rear. Oh my goodness, you've let him escape. You've let four men get away. Oh my goodness. And you, oh, what are you doing? Five men, that is unacceptable, sir. Snellhelm seems to have taken a back seat now. Yes, you stay back, sir. You've done your part. Look at... this. How are you guys holding out? Yes, we have reinforcements, men. We have reinforcements. Push, men. Full charge. Attack. Yes, wonderful. Right in the bum. That is excellent. Absolutely excellent. Hopefully, you're not going to catch them guys, are you? Wonderful. It is a glorious, glorious victory. Of course it is. Glorious victory, guys. Wonderful. Absolutely. Don't let them escape. They're trying to get away, men. Don't let them escape. There can be no survivors apart from the ones that have already got away. Wonderful. Okay. Well, there we go. Victory. Decisive victory. End the battle. Wonderful. 20 remaining. That is terrible. Snellhelm, you did a terrible job. There should have been none. That should be zero. No survivors, sir. No survivors at all. Wonderful. There we go. He is defeated. Yes. Excellent. Yes, we will occupy. Thank you. There we go. That is absolutely excellent. We've done really well there. We do need to replenish our men here, of course. We're going to go with Bard again. So this will help us with our unit replenishment, same as our king over here, of course. So that is absolutely excellent. All has gone really well there. Let us just have a quick check to make sure. Yes, okay. So there's a couple of unhappy people, but I'm sure they'll be fine for at least a couple of months, hopefully, fingers crossed. So that was absolutely excellent. So next time, yes, I know, guys, if you guys have really enjoyed it and been like, oh yes, right, what's next? Well, you're gonna have to wait. Next we're gonna go over here and get this place, of course. That will be no problem at all. Then we're gonna start a war with this guy. We're going to capture that. That will give us a lot more land, which is of course excellent. The more land we have, the more men we have, absolutely, of course. And then once that's happened, we're going to go and attack this guy. Hopefully by then, fingers crossed, the West Siaks will have started a war with these guys, so everybody will be all distracted and we can just swoop in and take his two bits of land. Absolutely wonderful. Well, you're going to have to wait until the next time, guys. We'll catch you in the next one.